Well, good morning, good evening, and good night. This is Todd the Blockbuster Guy, being Todd the Music Guy today. I wanted to switch it up and do my another top 10, but this one here is more of another ranking. I want to rank Maynard James Keenan bands and my favorite albums by Maynard and his other bands, being Tool, A Perfect Circle, and Pussifer. And I had to do this just because as you can tell, I'm a massive Tool fan. I've seen them six times, I did seven. I wanted to see them seven, but during the pandemic, I was going to see them in Edmonton, but they got delayed. Stupid pandemic, stupid COVID. But I'm going to start with my top 10 favorite Tool albums of all time. I'm going to start with my number one, actually, of Tool. It is Enema, or it's weird with Tool because you never really know what how to pronounce and stuff. They just make up words like lateralis and salival and stuff like that, or salival, lateralis as well, lateralis, salival, salival. But yeah, Enema, my first number one. It's my number one favorite album of all time, let alone my favorite Tool album. It's just that first like six tracks or so, seven tracks. Oh, the whole album is amazing. But Eulogy is my favorite song of all time. Hey, listen to Eulogy on a really good stereo, and if you like Tool, it'll blow your mind. And it's kind of based, I believe it's actually a eulogy for Bill Hicks. As he'd a lot to say, he'd a lot of nothing to say. Yeah, it's sometimes it's tough to do the rest of these top 10 or these ranking of Tool albums because Tool is so good, but like my ranking could change tomorrow. The next 10 minutes it could change, but as of right now, at this very moment, number two is Lateralis. It's like it 10,000 Days was big for a while, but like in my number two, but after watching a couple people review certain songs in Lateralis, like the Holy Trinity, that like it grows on me every time I listen to it. It's just crazy. That's Disposition, Reflection, and Triad, and fucking Lateralis alone, the actual title track of the album, using the Fibonacci sequence, check it out. It's Maynard says it's it's basically just kind of, it really isn't that big a deal. It's very cool though. It goes like 1, 2, 4, 8. I don't know. The Fibonacci sequence is, it's the spiral. Write the spiral to spiral out. Fucking Lateralis is so good. But like I said, every Tool album you can listen, just press play. Put it on, press play, good to go. The Grudge I saw live a couple times actually, but the first time I saw The Grudge live, Maynard, like, because that's like a minute long scream going, that's in that song, and it's fucking crazy. Craziness. But moving on to number three. This one was tough. I almost put 10,000 Days there, but I'm going to put Salival or Salivo just because of the live stuff. In my humble opinion, Push It Live is better than Push It on Enema or Enema. Push It Live is so good. It's so crazy listening to it. So people actually got to hear it live. I heard it live, but it wasn't as good as the Push It Live, the Salival one or Salival. It's so good. Plus they covered No Quarter, Led Zeppelin. They actually did it better than Led Zeppelin, which is nuts balls. What is it? They also covered You Lie. You Lied so good. And it's got like Jerk Off on there, I believe. I think Jerk Off's on there. Or Part of Me. One of the two. It's a live album that it just shows you how good Tool is live. Tool is amazing live. If you get a chance when after the pandemic to see Tool live, go see Tool live. Go see Tool live. So moving on to number four. My favorite Tool albums, 10,000 Days, released in 2006. I remember getting this album. It blew my mind because I saw them tour twice, I believe, off this album. One of the Molson Amphitheater. It was the Molson Amphitheater. I don't think it is the amphitheater anymore in Toronto. It was like a day after my birthday. It was amazing. I love Santo live. He came out though wearing like a Leafs jersey, and I believe they opened with the pot, because then you just see like Maynard. He's like, "Who are you to wave your finger? You must have been out your head." I can't do it. I can't hit that note. I'm not really a singer anyway though, but it's just like, holy fuck, Maynard, you're the man, bud. You're the man. Maynard is God. Maynard is God. So moving on to number five. The one that came out fucking 14 years after 10,000 Days. Fear Inoculum. I shed a tear when I heard Fear Inoculum for the first time, because they dropped Fear Inoculum before they dropped the entire album. So the actual title track of the album is Fear Inoculum. It's the first track on the album. When I heard it, I was like, oh my God, this is new Tool. This new Tool, this is fake, this is real. Blew my mind. Then I listened to the whole album, like, oh my God. I still can't really tell you what is my favorite song on that album. I jump all the time. At first, it was Numa. Then it was Tempest. Now it's Cult. I love Calling Voices. Love Calling Voices. Then Undertow. Like, I don't want to downplay any of these albums. They're all amazing, but, like, it's just slight differences that just I like a little bit better. Like Undertow, like my favorite track on Undertow is Crawl Away, hands down. But it's got Sober, that bass line. Fucking Prison Sex is so good too. Intolerance, fucking Flood. I can name every Tool song. Swamp Song, fucking Bottom with Henry Rollins. Fuck, it's so good. So then Opiate, like I was saying, this is only like 6 tracks on this album, but Fox Sweat's so good. Seems like I'm slipping into a dream within a dream. I'm gonna fuck it. This is gonna be a long video. I think I'm gonna go for about 15 minutes, because I'm talking about all of Maynard's bands. Fucking Opiate alone. And then you got the song after Opiate is I had a friend once, he took some acid. Now he thinks he's a fire hydrant. So I'm gonna move on to Perfect Circle. There was a super band that was kind of a collaboration of like Smashing Pumpkins, Tool, and Marilyn Manson, I believe. It was like the guitarist for Manson or bassist. It's a collaboration of 3 bands. People forget it. Basically, is a super band. But number one, this one wasn't my number one, but recently it kind of. But Maradonam, my number one favorite Perfect Circle album. So good. So good. It's just 3 Libras, fucking Judith, Magdalena, The Hollow, Orestes, Sleeping Beauty, so many good songs on this album. But I can name like all the songs on all of them. But 13th Step, number two, 13th Step, The Outsider and Pet, like those are two are very close. The boogeymen are coming, the boogeymen are coming, counting bodies like sheep to the rhythm of the war drums. Yeah, fucking 13th Step is great too. Once again, it's another album, just play it right through. But every major. And then Eat the Elephant. I'm gonna make this a little shorter. Eat the Elephant. They came out April 20th, like 2018, I think. 17? Might have been 2017. Really? I think it was 2018, I think it came out. I'll have to look it up. Put the edit right here once again. it's great too. Probably The Doomed, my favorite off this album. The Contrarian's great too. I was just listening to it yesterday. Is it Down by the River? Down by the River, I think, is the song. I think that's what it's called. It's so good too. There's Talk, even Eat the Elephant, the title track is great. Feathers, fucking Eat the Elephant is it. People kind of shit on it because it isn't as hard as like Maradonam and 13th Step. Tool fans are fickle. Then Tool fans are funny because they're like, Tool, that's it. Don't like A Perfect Circle. Don't like Pussifer. Tool. I'm like, Maynard, I don't care. Give me all Maynard. I'm fine with it. So number four, Emotive. The Motive is good, but there's a couple tracks on it. I'm not really a huge fan. I do sing Annihilation all the time. Some Just so good. Peace or annihilation. And passive, of course, as well. Fuck, passive is good. And counting bodies like sheep. It's a remix of Pet. They covered Imagine by John Lennon. Fuck. It's good too, but it's just, you know, the other three albums are a little bit better. Then I'm moving on to Pussifer. They did a lot of remixes, so I'm only going to do about six albums for Pussifer. Fuck. Conditions of My Parole is number one for Pussifer. This album is just righteous. Just righteous. So fucking good. From start to finish. The actual title track is amazing. The video is jokes too. It's really good. Fuck. There's a lot of good songs in this album. Man Overboard's great too as well. But like I said, check out Pussifer if you haven't. Just give them a chance. Yeah, like I can tell you a bunch of songs that are great. So moving on to number two, Money Shot. Money Shot's got fucking The Remedy on it. Just saying, that's my favorite Pussifer song of all time. The Remedy. Just fucking listen to it. The rest of the album's amazing too, but Remedy. And The Arsonist, that song just makes me laugh because it's like, fucking, what's the matter, Beavis? As I always think Beavis and Butthead. Then Existential Reckoning came out like last year, I think it was. It's got like apocalyptical. I think they wrote that song right before the fucking pandemic came out. And then the pandemic came out and they shot a video. The video is pretty cool too as well. But it fits in really well with COVID and what went on. It's a really good album too as well. The Bullet Train to Iowa. That one was Shut the Fuck Up. Fake a Front. That song's like my favorite on the album actually. So this is a good album. Good album. Then Via for Vagina. Number 4. Donkey Punch. Number 5. And number 6. C is for Please Insert Sophomoric Genitalia Reference Here. They're all good. They're all good. Beer for Vagina, the title track's amazing. I think Indigo Children's on that one too. Fuck. They put out a lot of Pussifer albums, actually. It's crazy. I just went with the 6, though, because a lot of them are remixes. But I just wanted to do this. Like, I was thinking about it yesterday when I was actually listening to A Perfect Circle. Like, I'm gonna put my Tool shirt on from the concert. I think in 2016, I think it was. And I just thought might as well rank them all. I knew it was going to be like a 13, 14 minute video. I could have gone longer. I just kind of rushed four through six of Pussifer. But they're all good. It's all good. Like I was saying, Maynard is fucking God. But this is Tyler, the Blockbuster Music Guy today. I'm going to sign off and I'm going to edit this one. And then I'm going to edit my day in the life of the Blockbuster Guy. And then I'm going to fucking upload them both. Well, I hope you guys have a good day. And I just thought I'd do this and hope you all have a good one. Peace. Like and subscribe and ring that bell.